journey is a little unusual. I did finish my PhD very quickly. I'm not sure I would recommend that. I worked incredibly hard to complete it in that time frame, actually because I didn't have enough funding, so there was a big pressure on me to finish quite quickly. But you know, in a way, that's not a bad thing. It makes you work very hard and stick to deadlines. Really passionate about mass spectrometry, even from the age of 16. I just really enjoyed using mass spectrometers. And then when I saw something I found interesting, I would always follow that up. So I really didn't choose anything particularly to study. I just happened across something that I found interesting and followed that line of research ever more. Spectrometry is incredibly powerful, of course, and biased, but it really does tell you not just the mass, but the interactions, the stoichiometry, even the shape, the connectivity of protein molecules. Really is incredibly powerful technique. And if you start to add on to that the sort of complexity of adding drugs and seeing how they disrupt complexes, you then have a very powerful technology. Interactions of proteins and other biomolecules. There's lots of very interesting research on DNA protein complexes and RNA protein complexes. And I think we're only just scratching the surface of how useful that's going to become in the future. There's still a long ways to go, but I'm excited about the fact that we have this very powerful technology that can be applied not just to proteins, but any other biomolecule. Lipids, I think it's particularly powerful. Once we found a way to transmit membrane proteins, we found that lipids always came with them. And at first we thought this was slightly irritating, but then we realised that these lipids were the key to the function and the structure of all these membrane proteins. And so now we've learned to get to love them and to get to try to understand them and to try to think about how they are modulating the function and the structure of these proteins. So I think it's very powerful. So I think it's always important to follow your passion. You have to be committed to research because it's very hard work, and there will be times when it doesn't work so well and you wonder why you're in that career and not in another one. But if you're really passionate about what you're doing, that sort of rides over those bad times, and then you get back to having the good times again. So it's really, you have to choose something that you love so that every day it becomes your passion and your hobby. And then that's the secret, I think.